The Smart Board is best utilized in a program called Smart Notebook. And so to get to Smart Notebook, you'll actually click on the Start menu in the lower left-hand corner of your screen, and you'll either look for or search in the search box for Smart Notebook. So I'll click on Smart Notebook 15 here. Some users throughout our district have Smart Notebook 14 or 12 or 11, depending on your image, and that's okay. They function the same. When Smart Notebook opens, it will function very much similar to a whiteboard that you would have in a classroom. So if I pick up a pen, I can immediately start drawing and writing on the board. Now, if you're writing and you start to notice that if you're writing over here, it's actually tracking over here, you may need to orient your board. To orient your board is very simple. You'll hold the two buttons here. Remember, we discussed the keyboard button and the mouse button. I hold them together. Once I release them, this screen will pop up, and my job is to be as accurate as possible by pressing in the center of the target. So I can drag and release, or I can press and click. But regardless of your approach, it records the last point of release on the board. And so there are usually 9 of these to complete, and you're finished. Now, students absolutely love doing that, so I would encourage you to try and use students if you need help with that. Once you've drawn on the smart board, everything that goes onto the screen becomes an object. So for example, this squiggly line, I can now select and move around the board where I would want it to be. I can also drag from the right corner to make it bigger or smaller, and this green dot here will allow me to rotate the image. There are also a lot of advanced features that we don't have time to cover today, but that you might want to investigate underneath the drop-down on the corner of the object. So again, to get there, I selected the object, and I clicked the drop-down, and here are all of those additional options you may be interested in using. Now, we discussed the eraser, but it works simply by erasing just as you would on a standard whiteboard. If you want to show your students that you really know your stuff, you can circle around the content you want to erase and tap in the center, and it will go away. Now, if you're taking notes with a student or with a class and you've worked down the page, you realize that you're out of room, you have a couple of options here. The first option is that you can click Extend Page at the bottom. This will give you essentially more paper space, if you will, as you work. The cost of this, though, is that it actually moves what you were working on above and it shrinks the view of everything. So my personal preference is to click the plus button up here in the left-hand corner to add a page. You'll notice that in the page sorter on the left-hand side of your screen, the first page I was working on is the first slide, and the next page I'm working on is the second slide. This gives me the ability to continue working with whatever it was that I was demonstrating on, and if we need to go back and revisit that previous slide, I can click here. Now, besides just the pen tray that's located here, there's a whole toolbar in Smart Notebook that is across the top of the screen here. Remember, everything that I'm clicking here up here at the smart board, you can also be clicking with at your computer at any time from your mouse or from your keyboard or what you're used to using. So up here along the top, we've already talked about adding a page. I can also use this page icon with the red X to delete a page. So if I decided I didn't want page 1 anymore, I can select page 1 and click delete. Now, the all necessary undo button is right here in case you realize you've done something you don't want to do. A lot of these features here are more advanced features. However, there is one that's really useful as you're starting to get to know your smart board. It's the screen shade. And so it looks like a screen that you would pull down from for maybe an overhead projector you used to use. If you click that, you'll notice that it covers the content on my page. Now I can pull down from the top, or I can move in from the side if there are certain portions of the page that I want to release. Very similar to what you may have done with an overhead with pieces of paper on top of your transparency and moving them around to reveal answers or sections of the page. When I'm done with it, I select the red X in the upper right-hand corner and it goes away. Right here, however, looks very similar to Microsoft tools as far as adding shapes or adding colors. I can also just click here and use the pen tools from the top of the board. This is particularly useful if you're having students come up and use the board and you don't want them to have to take one of these pens out of the pen tray. So by clicking on the pen icon, I can select the pen that I want to use. Now there are a bunch of different pens here that you can investigate. I'll just use a standard pen here, green in color. So I've selected it, and I can actually write on the board using my finger. The elementary smart board only allows for one touch. So you can only have one person up here writing at a time, and you can't have multiple, you can't be touching the board in multiple locations. I'll also encourage you to not drag your palm like I used to, because it will make the smart board do some crazy things. So now that I've written here, if I tried to go back and say select this line because it's an object, you'll notice that when I go to click on it, I'm actually making small green dots. That's because I still have the pen picked up. So I need to go back to the cursor view so that I can click on my word welcome, and now I can move it anywhere that I wanted to move it or use it like that. If you choose to drop in a shape from the shape tool, so for example, if I drop in a triangle, I've selected the shape tool, selected triangle, and now my finger becomes a triangle drawing machine. So I draw here, and when I release, I have a triangle on the board. If I go back and try and click on something though, I'm going to keep drawing triangles, which might be frustrating if you don't know to click right back here on the cursor icon. Now, if you go to get your eraser and you want to erase this line or you want to erase the triangle, you'll notice that I can erase the line, but I cannot erase the triangle. That's because anything that isn't handwriting, the eraser will not work on. So to do anything different, you'll have to go ahead and select your cursor tool again, select the icon or the shape or whatever you've inserted that you want to get rid of, and I can click on the red X here to delete it off of my page. Again, I click on a shape or object that I want to get rid of, I click the red X, and it's deleted. You can use this in as many different ways that you want to. But when you're finished, if you want to save what you've worked on with students, you simply go up here to the corner like you would in many programs, select File, and select Save. Now here in the Park Hill School District, we ask that you save to your Documents folder located over here on the left. When you click on Documents, you can give it a title, and that document, once saved, will follow you no matter where you are in the Park Hill School District. If you are sent a smart notebook to open, it's the same idea. If you are on a district-provided computer, all district computers have smart notebook installed. So you'll just simply double-click on the file that you've received, and it will open a smart notebook lesson for you to work through. So those are the basics of Smart Notebook. If you have additional questions, please don't hesitate to contact the Department of Technology or the Department of Instructional Technology, and we'd be more than happy to help.